Welcome everybody to My Life. It's an up-tempo song. Give yourself a little bit of time for that, but every great song you master makes you a little bit happier. Enjoy, let's go. Welcome everybody to my help section for this song. And there are a few moments that will give you headache, but they will give you a really bad headache. And the worst part in this song is not the right hand, it's the left hand, although it's just playing octaves. That's the whole point. So, you know, this needs practicing. This needs practice. What you do is you start slowly, really make it regular. That's the thing to do. Start slowly but regular. Then after a while, you know, make sure it's coming from the wrist, everything. Otherwise, after 1 minute down the piece, you will freeze, your face will turn green and blue, and then the whole thing explodes. Then you take your hand off the keyboard, put it in your lap or on your head if you like it, or if on your dog's head, and then you come back. and you will see it's getting already a little bit better. You do that day after day for a while, every time a little bit. It does not help you if you do it for 1 hour. Like, I promise you, too much effort is counterproductive. So, of course, the rest is most of the time, it's straightforward, except in the B part. But let's have a look at the melody. Why did Christian say it's straightforward? Is he again this pathological liar we know him as? And well, you know, there is the slow replay coming for you to learn at your own speed. I will focus on the tricky bits. And well, let's have a look briefly at the intro, okay? Because we have this. And now, I promise you, the first time you play this, you think, Christian, how can he do this? It's E-flat major 7. How can he dare to do this? I hate him. I will follow him. I track him down. Hey, come down. God has given you this hand just to play the E-flat major 7. It's a typical thing for students. The stress is too much for the occasion. You know, first I play like, oh, E-flat, never played that. And then if you realize, hey, come on, hey, it's the same thing when I put my hand down on any table. It's just that, okay? And if you realize that the stress is too much, you know, calm down, people. And that is all not a problem at all, okay? Now, okay, let's go to this thing you're all dreading. You will not play this, I promise you. You can play the piece, but at the speed, you will not be able to play this. This can be just played by, I don't know, Max Planck and me. And I played faster than Max Planck. You don't even know him, right? So, we simplify that you can play it and not like give up the whole piece, okay? That's what you do, one and two. And you might have realized or not what my left hand is doing in order to tie these octaves. Now, look at my left hand, please. Just to remind you, it's this one. It was not funny, Christian. Okay. So, one and two and three and four and one and two and three and four and one and... What did I do, for example, to get from the D down to the, what is it? From the C, sorry. Now from the C, we want to go to the F and I play. I anticipate the last note from the previous chord, for in this case from C, and I anticipate the F already. This way I can tie these really rather nicely. And two, and three, and four, and one. Now imagine this without. One, and two, and three, and four, and... You gotta be fast. You gotta let go of the keyboard. You lose control. You cannot tie it. That's why you do this. One, and two, and three, and four, and one, and two. So we have a look at the melody and what it actually is. This is so... You know, what the left hand gives you in headache, the right hand gives you as a fresh breeze that's easy to play. Why? Okay. Let's have a look at the D major chord. Not the major 7 chord, but just the D major triad as an inversion. Can you see these notes? Of course you can see them. If your monitor is switched on bright and nice, then you should see it. Now, see these notes, and now see what the melody is doing. He's just playing chord notes. That's the only bit. And now watch again, watch again, watch again, watch again. And then we have A. The A chord is this one, right? Now watch his melody. Here. It's the chord notes. Well, that's genius to turn chord notes into a hit. Okay, so that's really easy to remember. And you just add the chord note I'm giving you, and then we come to G. You don't have to play this fast arpeggio. He does it. But he's a master piano player. Did you know that? He studied piano, I think, in Berkeley. He's a real gifted piano player. Wow, that's really, heaven's gift, being a great piano player and a great singer. No wonder he's a millionaire, but I get there. So, bam, bam, bam. And here we are at the next point. You don't play this unless you want, unless you can. You can just play it without this grace note, without this accidental, or as they call it, the power killer slide. And then it repeats. Easy peasy, huh? And then we have this, I'll show you briefly. The D stays on top. Here. We are here on A, and then, on G, and then G. And only watch my lower two fingers. They go two down. They go two down. Here. Just the thirds wander down, and then you hit the D on all of them. Here. Okay. And then we have the intro again, then we have the verse repeating. And blah 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 until we reach the moment of truth. Then we come first B part. A wonderful Christian, sounds nice, but it's not right. It's the B minor 7 here. Ever heard of that? Ever played that? Okay, now. And then F7, fifth F sharp 7, which you probably also never heard about, yeah? You thought it is a cocktail or a drink from, I don't know, Guatemala. The F sharp 7. Here, but I'll play just the chord notes. Can you see it? All chord notes of the F sharp 7 chord. Then, these chord changes are just magical. And now we're coming to A. Rhythm killer, interesting point here. Here we are coming from E7, and with really hot mustard in your bum, you play this. Yay! E7, F. You just learned that. G. Okay. And we are back in business. So, and here now comes what I find the hard bit to play, like so now this is actually, apart from the left hand, the hardest moment. Let's have a look what we do. The left hand is we are playing, and then, you know, 1 and 2 and 3 and 4 and 1 and 2 and 3 and now, firstly look at the left hand, 1 and 2 and 3 and 4 and 1 and 2 and 3 and 4 and 1. That's the line. We're coming from D, 3 and 4, our old trick. 1 and 2 and 3 and 4 and connecting the F sharp 7 with the D minor 7, okay? So you practice that separately. Yes, now we have a look at the right hand separately. Now, here, we are in F sharp 7. You know that, you learned that just now. Yeah, and this will cause some of you to have symptoms here of rashes between your fingers. Maybe even your skin is breaking because the span is too big. If you can play it, that's really nice. Yeah? If you cannot play it, especially this one and this one with these two together, you just play. You just omit. Sorry. Why do we keep the 7? The 7, because the 7 is really important in this chord. It's a F sharp 7, and you know, always keep either the 3rd or the 7. I told you in my last tutorial about reharmonization or harmonization of a song. So then it would be. Sounds almost as nice, huh? And then we are in E. And again, you don't have to play this killer move. You may, but you don't have to. G over A, G over A. Then comes the next spot, and we go straight to the next B part, second B part, because there is the same what we did here. We do there. So in these, I find the two hardest bits, apart from the left-hand octave repetition. Okay, let's have a look. The first one was coming from F sharp 7. We repeat this, the F sharp 7 chord, F sharp chord, plus the 7 here. So the first one was, and entering into the B minor 7. The other one, second time it's coming, we start here with the F. We are not having the F7 here. You see? It's a bit easier to play because we don't have this stretch. Here. And then in the B minor 7. So the verses down here and the verses up here are repeating. Good for you. The B part is exactly repeating except and this bit. Otherwise, it's the same. The hook line is repeating. You see? Mm-hmm. You can manage this monster. This beautiful monster. The monster, what is it called? The Beauty and the Beast. Are you a beauty? Then you can play this beast. And that's basically about it. And then you start like this. Because I really can't stand pop or rock piano up-tempo for two ambitious young pundits who think they can master it and they can, and they play it like they come back after a week and I can't play it like. Yeah. I might be laughing, but I've experienced that a billion times. And now it's a slow replay for you. Go learn it. It's a wonderful piece. See you afterwards. Thank you. So did you manage? It's a bit tougher, huh? But as we say in Germany, you grow with a task. But I think they say that in any country, right? Anyway, if you like my tutorial, give me a thumbs up down there. Stay healthy, stay safe. Bye-bye from Berlin.